Hey folks, it's Friday and it's video time. Today another video about my series, about my Asia Sentinel series. But before we start, I'd like to give you a short introduction about me. My name is Hannes Lagler-Gröner. I'm a multi-cloud architect in one of the biggest consulting company in Austria. I'm working since 2012 with public cloud, mainly focusing on Microsoft Asia at the beginning. But over the time, I'm realizing it's a good idea to go more broader and also specialize into AWS and GCP. You can find my social profile on Twitter, Xing, LinkedIn, Facebook, and so on. And if you are looking for a good blog, you can also visit my blog, cloudblogger.at. Okay, enough from me. So let's talk about the session from today. In one of my last videos, I'm showing you the functionalities about Asia Sentinel, so the basic, and then another video about watch lists. And today I want to show you how you can use Asia DevOps to implement infrastructure as code and also deploy over CI/CD pipelines your analytics rules, for example, and your playbooks. So really cool stuff. It's a level 2, level 300 session, so a little bit more deeper into the technical details. So keep this in mind and enjoy the video. So I will switch over to my demo environment. Okay, we are now opened Visual Studio Code, and you see I have opened two JSON templates. One JSON template is for my rule and one for my analytics rule, and another JSON template is for my playbook. So let's have a look to the JSON itself. So we have on the top we have the schema, we have the content version, we have parameters. In this case, this is the rule, analytics rule area. So we have here our analytics rule name. This is a parameter, and we also need our workspace name. Okay, so let's have a look to the resource itself. So we have one resource, one analytic rule in this JSON template. It's from type alert rules. From name perspective, we have implement a concat, so we are using the parameters and so on. We also implement the location. The location is always based on the location from the resource group. It's a scheduled rule. Here are the description about the rule, the discipline name. It's enabled rule for sure. Here is the custom query and the frequency, and also an important part, the entity mapping. Entity mapping is always used for analytics. It's also used for the playbooks. So when you execute a playbook, you will send the entities also to the playbook and can work with those entities. So in this case, I'm using a custom query to analyze the audit logs, and in this case, I want to create an incident when a conditional access policy is updated, is added, or is deleted. So keep this in mind. And if the incident is executed, we also add entities named account. In this case, the full name. This is the initiated by variable, and the URL is the policy name in this case, and so on. We also have the process. So the process gives me the information what kind of process is executed. In this case, maybe an add, remove, or update policy. Okay, so really easy, really simple. You can use that policy from my GitHub, not the policy, you can use the template from my GitHub channel if you want. Then the second one, we have here a playbook. So we have one parameter, the playbook name only. We have three variables for each connection. So in this case, we deploying an playbook, an Azure Sentinel playbook, to block and revoke the user session, to block a user and revoke also the user session. So we have three connections. We have one connection to Sentinel, for example, for sure. We have the connection for Azure Active Directory, and we have a connection for the monitoring logs. Okay, so first of all, we are initializing the connections itself. So we have here a Microsoft Web connection from type, in this case, this is Sentinel, Azure Sentinel. So we need this connection to write back. First of all, we need the connection to get the incident. Then we need the connection to write back a comment to the incident. Then we have a second connection from type Azure AD, because we want to block the user and revoke the session. This is the reason why we have to implement an Azure AD connection. And the third connection is for log analytics. You can see here Azure monitoring logs. So we need this log analytics connection because we want to receive the emergency accounts, in this case from one of my watch list, which is based in Azure Sentinel. So this is the reason why we also have to implement the Azure log analytics connector. And at the end, we want to deploy a workflow from Microsoft Logic. So this is a Logic app with depends on the parameters. It's also a system assigned managed identity available. And here we have the definition. We have the workflow steps itself in place. Okay, so that's it. That's from the template. So you can use the template. You can download the template from my GitHub repository if you want. And we've changed something. So we now commit the changes and push it to our Azure DevOps repository. So let's open the command line, click git add. So I want to add everything. Next, I want to commit. In this case, I'm updating my playbook and also my analytics rules. So I comment add the information to the comment. And at the end, I will execute the git push. So now all my changes are pushed to my GitHub repository, into my dev repository. I'm now switch over to my Azure DevOps environment. So you can see here, I have my repository, my playbooks, my analytics rules. I have here two branches. I have my dev and my master branch. So I'm changing everything on my dev branch. And now I have to implement, or I have to execute a pull request. So in this case, I'm creating a new pull request, update analytics rules and so on, from my dev branch to my master branch. Click on create. So I'm add a policy. I'm add a branch policy that that one user have to commit the pull request. So I'm now approve the request. So I can approve it self. So it's not the best idea, but for the example, it's good. And then you can see here, I've implemented a pipeline. Hopefully the pipeline is running in a few seconds. Oh, I'm sorry, I forget something for sure. So let's go back to the pull request. So I've approved the pull request, but it's still open. So we have to complete the pull request. It's an active pull request. So we complete the pull request. I'm using the merge type fast forward. So no fast forward, but I don't delete the old branch, I leave it. So click on complete merge. So now the pull request is completed. So let's switch back to my pipelines. And you can see here my pipeline is now executing. It's a YAML pipeline, and you can see here what happens, the job itself, and here the job is initializing. You can see here checkout demo sentinel, now a resource manager deployment is starting, and the second one is for the analytics rule. The second one is for my Asia playbook. So let's wait some seconds till the pipeline is finished, and then let's go back. Okay, the job is now finished, so everything is green, everything is running fine. So let's switch back to my Sentinel environment. So we have here Asia Sentinel. Let's open the Asia Sentinel service, click on analytics, and you can see here we have one new analytics rule. Scroll down. Here we are. Here is my analytics rule. Here you can see this is the audit log, category policy, the update policy, add policy, delete policy, and so on. And we have a new automation task, exactly a playbook named block and revoke user session. So everything is in place. Everything is executed or installed by a CI/CD pipeline. Really cool stuff, really easy to implement. So keep this in mind when you're using Asia Sentinel. From the beginning, you are starting with the configuration inside the portal, but in near future, change your process into infrastructure and as code and deploy the analytics rules, hunting rules, playbooks, automation tasks over infrastructure as code. So that's it. That's from my new series about Asia Sentinel. So I hope you enjoy the video. You can find all source codes on my GitHub channel. GitHub repo, I'm sorry. So that's it. Have a nice weekend and see you soon.